Hi friends, welcome to Slide Hunt with C programming video tutorial. In this tutorial, I am going to teach you how to sort an array. Sorting means arrange the elements in a sequence. It may be lowest to highest, which is called ascending order, or highest to lowest, which is called descending order. Here we arrange the elements in ascending order, means lowest number to highest number. There are many techniques to sort an array, but here we apply the simplest one, which is called bubble sort. So let's start. Here our first task is to declare an array which holds the numbers that we want to store. So I'm going to write here int, then array name, that is list, and then within square bracket write how many numbers you want to sort. Suppose we want to sort 10 numbers, so I'm going to write here 10. Then we need to declare some other variables which we use in our program, and they are temp, swap, and I. Next, I am going to ask user to enter numbers. Printf, please enter numbers that you want to sort, and then backslash n. Next, we need to read the numbers that the user entered. So I'm going to write here for I equal to 0, I less equal to 9, and then I plus plus. Here we use scanf function to read the number. Scanf percent d, and here we refer ampersand list I. Next, we sort the array elements, but before writing the code, first we see the logic of how to sort array elements using bubble sort. Here we take 4 numbers, 23, 10, 19, and 5. Now we sort this number using bubble sort. So what we do here? First we compare 23 and 10. If first number is greater than second number, then we swap these two numbers. Here 23 is greater than 10, so we swap these two numbers and we get this one. Then we compare 23 and 19. 23 is greater than 19, so we swap this number, and after swapping we get this one. Then we compare these two numbers, 23 and 5. 23 is greater than 5, so we swap these two numbers, and after swapping we get this one. Step 1 is completed. Similarly, we write step 2. First we compare these two numbers, 10 and 19. 10 is less than 19, so we no need to swap. We get this one. Then we compare these two numbers, 19 and 5. 19 is greater than 5, so we swap these two numbers, and after swapping we get this one. Then we compare these two numbers, 19 and 23. 19 is less than 23, so we no need to swap, and we get this one. Similarly, we perform the step 3. In step 3, first we compare these two numbers, 10 and 5. 10 is greater than 5, so we swap these two numbers, and after swapping we get this one. Then we compare these two numbers, 10 and 19. 10 is less than 19, so no need to swap, and we get this one. Then we compare 19 and 23. 19 is less than 23, no need to swap, and finally we get this one. And now you can see the numbers are sorted. Here it takes 3 steps to sort the number, but it is not fixed. Number of steps required to solve a problem is depend on in which sequence or order we take the number. If we take the number in this order, means first 10, then 5, then 19, and then 23, then we need only one step. Let's move to the coding. Since we don't know how many steps are required to sort an array, so here we use an infinite loop. While 1, and then a pair of curly braces. This is an infinite loop. In programming, 1 is indicate true. So this loop will be execute infinite times. There is only one condition to come out of this loop, that is when a break statement will be encountered. So what we do here? Here we perform the sorting, and when the list is sorted, we add a break and the control come out of the loop. So the first thing that we need to do in slice swap equal to 0. Then we perform some operations, and at the end we check swap again. If it is 0, then the list is sorted. Otherwise, we set swap equal to 1 and execute the loop again. Next, we sort the numbers. I am going to write here for I equal to 0, I less equal to 9 minus 1, and then I plus plus. Here we write the condition I less equal to 9 minus 1, because here we compare every number with the number after it. See here, first we compare these two numbers, then compare these two numbers, and then we compare these two numbers. So we need three comparison, which is 1 less than the number of digit. If there are 10 digits, then we need 9 comparison. That's why we write here I less equal to 9 minus 1, because 9 minus 1 is 8, and 0 to 8 indicates the loop will be executed 9 times. The next thing that we need to do, check every number with the number after it. For that, I am going to write here if list I greater than list I plus 1. If this condition is true, means first number is greater than second number, then we swap this true number. First we copy the first number to a temporary variable, that is temp equal to list I. Then we copy second number to first number, that is list I equal to list I plus 1. And then list I plus 1 equal to temp. These three statements swap two numbers, and then we set swap equal to 1. Because if we swap the numbers, means list is not sorted. That's why we set here swap equal to 1. Next, after the for loop, we check the value of swap. If it is 0, then come out of the loop. So I am going to write here if swap equal to 0, then add break. The last thing that we need to do, print the sorted list. So I am going to write here printf sorted list is, then we use here a for loop to print the list. So I am going to copy it and paste here, and then we use printf statement to print the sorted number. Printf %d / n, and here we refer list I. Here I do some mistake, it would be I plus 1. And now check the output, compile and run. As you can see here, it asks for numbers. I am going to enter 25, 13, 24, 12, 5, 31, 20, 53, 11, and 44. And the sorted list is this: 5, 11, 12, 13, 20, 24, 25, 31, 44, and finally 53. That's it. Hope you understand. If you have any doubt, please comment on the video. Thanks for watching. To watch more videos, please subscribe this channel SlideHunt. You can like my Facebook page at www.facebook.com/slidehunt. And you can follow me on Google Plus at www.google.com/plus/slidehunt.